The capital city of Kampala, known as the Seven Hills City, has hosted one of the most successful International Association of Athletics Federation World Cross Country Championships, and many of the countries here are participating with their flags being represented there, indicating that they're here to make history. And Uganda has been one of them, taking gold. As you can see, many of them are sloping down and moving up and down. It looks like today will be one of those days Ugandans will never forget.
I was very happy because I saw the crowd. The crowd were very many. People were very happy. Not that we were supporting only Uganda. Personally, I was supporting everybody. And I was very happy for the performance of everybody and every country.
Mr. Kamlegea, how was today's cross-country championship?
Oh, pretty exciting and very interesting, very inspiring.
What was so unique?
The uniqueness is that probably this is the first time we're having this event in this country.
Today is, I want to win Somalia, but it's not win.
Okay, so yeah. So how did you feel about the support from Uganda here?
I will support Uganda very well, but now I don't know number three or number two, I don't know Uganda now.
Yeah. We didn't do as well as Uganda, but they ran fast, they were good.
How did you feel about the cheering from Ugandans, especially as Jacob Kiplimo won the gold?
Oh, that was phenomenal. It was great to be a part of. We pretended that we were Ugandan for a little bit.
Do you like more functions like this to take place in Kampala?
In fact, Kampala is the best place, very clean, organized. I'm seeing even the security. People are well disciplined. So maybe in Olympics or World Championship to be held here. Hotels are good. In fact, you sleep some of the hotels here.
I enjoyed Ugandans. Ugandan, the under 20 men won, and it was really amazing.
So we did not win the men races, but we are proud. We have Kiprotich, who comes from Uganda. But that boy is the son of our soil, Kenya. We are also proud of him. And we are happy the ladies have actually made us great.
How was the race? What's
the
your name?
The race was fine.
Mm-hmm. What did you like about the race?
I liked what they were doing.
Okay. Whom were you supporting? Which country were you supporting?
Uganda.
Uganda, Uganda.
I was supporting Uganda.
Did it win?
Yeah, no. Yes.
Did you win any gold medal?
No. It's a bit too hot for us, really.
Yeah.
Bit too hot.
It was too hot,
eh? Yeah, too hot.
So what kind of temperatures did you want?
Well, at home at the moment it's about 10 degrees. That's warm. So up to about 20 is probably our limit, would we say?
How many girls, how many boys did you have today?
We had 6 junior boys, 6 junior girls and 4 senior women.
How did it feel to have these championships in Kampala? The weather, how was it?
It was definitely a challenge for our athletes because we are not necessarily used to these temperatures. But it was a good learning experience, and I'm sure these guys will move forward from it and use it for future races.
Finally, the International Association of Athletics Federation World Cross Championships have come to an end here in Kampala, and most of them are departing and leaving for their homes. But many of them will live with the memories that have taken place here this afternoon, and will live to tell them in the future. However, what we can also conclude with is that sport has likely brought many cultures together, many tribes and many races, and it will be one of the combining factors that will progress the next future of a new generation of sportsmen and women. Andrew Nitwe, NTV, Kampala.